Alright, you wanna play first? Yeah. This hand's okay, I guess. Question mark. Kind of obnoxious how fast it's being every single time. Whether I want to play it or cycle it. But I mean, I suppose it has to. It's just one of the things about using Moto. I'm not gonna force a Delver. Cycle this here, only sandbar here. Actually, I'm gonna play the Underground Sea and cycle the other one. Much, yeah, just now. Doesn't really matter when I do it. Okay, so we do have a white source setup for next turn. Good to know. Gonna either get probably a basic plane since we have the second source posture, so if he wastes the Tundra, if we were to tutor out a Tundra, then things could get awkward. I don't think I would force a Stoneforge Mystic either. I think I would just let it resolve and then pop a Stoneforge. Redundant Delver, yeah, that's fine. This deck's interesting. Does interesting things. Drawing redundant Sundials is not a good feeling. Yes, you guys were wondering if that was a good feeling or not. Yeah, he's going for the Stifle. This time at least we can, like, miscalculate, I guess? I don't know. But if he has, I mean, if he has a daze, he just gets the daze here. Okay, cool. The only awkward thing about that was now he's got free reign to resolve True Name. But I didn't want to let him get two Delver flips with a fetch land. That's just, like, a lot of filtering to get for free when you can cast your Swift Depositaries as a sorcery. And avoid the whole thing. Flips, revealing Power Blast, that's fine. Good to know about them. It's maximum for three, that's fine. I take three, whatever. Ship's turn. Draw land. I'm going to play this. Just gonna plow this guy. Yeah, I care, like, not that much about a Delver. I care so much about True Name. Spell Pierce is so good. Good thing I have a redundant Sundial. It's always gonna be a card that they're gonna fight over, too. So that's why you have to run the four Sundials, is because people are going to kill them or fight over them or all that nonsense. I think he's deciding whether or not he wants to brainstorm. Okay, he's plundering. It's fine. Yeah. What's a good draw for me? Well, he tapped his red source. So I could just, like, if I had a JC here, I could just slam it. He is not holding up Pyroblast. The Ideas Unbound would have been the ideal draw. I'm not knocking the redundant forcible. Like, at least it's a blue card. I was thinking about Trinket Mage for Dreadnought in this show, and then you could always, like, blink the Trinket Mage with Slide or whatever. But Trinket Mage for Dreadnought would allow me to also run Engineered Explosives, which is a way to deal with Counterbalance if a control opponent gets it down before I get down Sundial, which can be an issue. I'm just gonna hard cast a Force of Will on this card. I'll get a few non-basics, whatever. What was I talking about? Oh yeah, Trinket Mage. Trinket Mage. You can get the Dreadnought. You can also get a piece of Graveyard Hate, like the Grafdigger's Cage or Nihil's Spellbomb or something. And then, dang it, now he's holding up Pyroblast, so I can't just jam this Ideas Unbound. I'll just pass the turn. I was hoping he wouldn't be able to hold up Pyroblast. Oh, there was an interesting card I could get with Trinket Mage. Oh, yeah, Meek Stone. So Meek Stone and Engineered Explosives would both be answers to a potential True Name Nemesis, which might make the deck a little bit stronger, just to like have that out. Like I said, the deck is very, very new and untested. He's left the Force of Will Resolve, which is scary. It means that he is valuing his Pyroblast very highly. It also means I'm not going to just fire off this Ideas Unbound. I could just draw Thoughtseize and like Thoughtseize the Pyroblast and start drawing cards and run away with the game that way. So, Wasteland, that's fine, whatever. I already did basic planes, so figured Shooting Nemesis, sure. I think he got the idea that I was like kind of cold to that card after the last game. Okay. Oh yeah, I'm gonna slow dredge this guy. I'm gonna make my opponent sit through it too. We got a 3-3, buddy. What do you got? Five mana, 3-3 draw card. Although, if he'd had a creature, it would have been 5 mana, 3-3 draw card, and exile target creature and opponent controls. Jay. I don't think I have a card that can deal with any of this. I think I am super dead to what he's doing over there. The good news is, this Ideas Unbound might resolve. Okay. Oh, we have multiples. We're just gonna like draw through our deck and then look embarrassed when we can't actually kill them. Draw 6 cards in one turn. I think when I made the deck, I just kind of assumed that if I could draw just all the cards, then I mean, how could you not win, you know? Just have like the win locked up. I wasn't thinking about problem permanents. Like what my opponent has on the board. And so if I cast this dragon, I don't think that actually helps me very much. Could be a shuffle effect here. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I could have some kind of creature that just like bricks whatever my opponent's doing. Obviously, I don't have one, but. Alright. Oh god. Almost made myself discard 6. Should have left up the planes, I guess. I don't know. Casting Eternal Dragon and dredging back freaking Viscera Draggers is not a good win condition. I don't know what I was thinking. It's just too dumb. It's just way too dumb. What's a good way to kill people in a format of like True Name Nemesis and stuff? Oh, he's lethaling me. Alright, that's fair. Good game, sir. You have successfully True Named me. Yeah, both games 1 and 2, I probably could have let a few cards resolve that were not True Name Nemesis, since I'm just like stupidly cold to this card, and I don't actually care about the rest of his deck. So, not really well played. However, the sub-goals of, like, activating Sundial of the Infinite and doing ridiculous things is pretty amazing. That has certainly happened to great success.